Well, everyone, Josh is again, and today I'm in Troy, Ohio. Troy, Ohio comprises an area of about 12.4 square miles, and it's about 19 miles north of Dayton, Ohio. The population is 26,432. It's the largest city in Miami County and the 55th largest city in the state of Ohio.
Really a cool looking city too. Look at this. Love that building. Guess what, son? We got a train coming right now. Northbound auto racks train. So go ahead and start the video. Here we go. Troy, Ohio.
Wow, that's a lot of auto racks. I think they're all empty though. Headed northbound. It's still pretty foggy out. It's about 7:15 a.m. right now. Ooh, way too early for me. Ah, but wait, there's more. Of course, so is this. Hey, before I got here, I stopped over at Piqua, Ohio on Garvey Road, and I filmed the train there at about 6:04 a.m. It was very, very foggy out, so check this out, and we'll come back to Troy again. One thing I really like about Troy are these old color position lights. These are old Baltimore and Ohio color position lights. These things are ancient and they still use them. There's not many of these left. I wish it would show up on here. When it's dark outside, they'll show up really good. It's showing red right now. The one on the bottom, you can see a little bit better. It's brighter and it's in a shaded area. That's a dwarf signal right there. Do you know where there's any of those? Those are getting really hard to find. There's also a signal on the other side, facing the other direction. I'll show that one too. We're at milepost 79 on the Toledo sub, Troy, Ohio. Here's a real close-up look at this dwarf signal. Look at that. Is that cool or what? There's the back side of it. There you go. Here's a close look up at this. Look at this, got a ladder. I'd love to climb up there. Actually, I used to do that when I was a teenager. I've climbed up those things before. I don't do it anymore. That's pretty cool. Man, I love that old stuff. When I was a kid, these things were all over the place. This is one of the last of its kind.
And here's the other side, right next to the old train station. Look at this, it just went to yellow. Amber on top and yellow. It was red when I went to the other side. So we're gonna have something lined up to go south. Oh, this will be awesome. I'm gonna head over to the railroad bridge and get a train going over that bridge southbound. That'd be a great shot going over the Great Miami River. Let's go over there. There's a bird sitting there on the bridge. Look at that, it's not even moving. It might be a blue heron, I'm not really sure. It's too far away for me to really see it very good. Reminds me of being down here in Florida, get those big birds standing on the docks. But the train's gonna be coming through in just a minute. I heard them on the scanner. Heard them on 160.230 calling out the signals. So they'll be here anytime. This is the Great Miami River. I heard them on the radio say no defects, and they got 284 axles at milepost 82.7. The engineer actually acknowledged the defect detector, so that was interesting. This is a southbound train. I bet it's gonna be another one of those auto rack trains. 284 axles, not a whole lot of axles, but it could still be a long train. Those auto racks are about 91 feet long, each one. Here comes the train. The bird is right there. It is really hazy and overcast today. Let's see what the bird does. I'm gonna zoom in on him. There he goes. All right, that was awesome. At least it wasn't an auto racks train this time. They get a lot of auto racks through here. That was a good train to mix freight, not real long. Well, it's been a pretty good day over here. Had a nice day. I'm gonna start heading south. Might run over to Tipp City, see what's going on over there. They got some more of those old B&O signals, and I heard that they tore out a passing siding in Tipp City. I wanna have a look at that. So thanks for watching, everyone. If you have time, watch another video of mine. Every view helps my channel and helps pay for that gas. It takes a lot of gas anymore to get around. Thanks for watching. All right, so this thing has a clear signal now for a northbound train. That should show up right there. We got a train coming with 184 axles, northbound, and they're about 6 miles away from me right now. So they're coming from that direction right there. Got the signal dropping. You gotta look really close to see it though. I got it. All right, there you go. That was a good train. Really interesting crossing here too. Similar to street running, the way that it's really long, the way that the track is down the road. Pretty cool. Thanks for watching, everyone. Let's have a look here. Alrighty, that's an interesting crossing. Alright, I'm in Tipp City now, and they sure did take out the other track. The passing siding right here, look at this. They ripped it out. That was done since last time I was here. That's a shame. Look at that. Took the whole thing out. And there's a dwarf signal right down that way at the next crossing. I guess that's still there. I'm going to go down and have a look. Okay, so I moved down to another crossing here. And the dwarf light is still on. Look at this. Even it's got one bulb out. Even with the track being removed, the switch and everything, it's still on. And the other light is on too, showing a red. Looking that direction north, that's the crossing I was just at a minute ago, way down that way, about a mile or more. So yeah, they took the entire thing out. There you go, downtown Tipp City. Here's a closer look at the switch. Still got the switch motor in place. Everything else is gone. There's also another signal down there, two roads down on the left. You can see the back of it. Pretty cool stuff. CSX main one.
Wow, that was a long train there. No wonder it went a couple hours without a train. Make them that long, that's literally two trains in one. Ooh, that was a good one. Well, that's about it for me for today. I gotta head back about 100 miles to back home. I think it's actually a little bit more than 100 miles. I'm not really sure. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you got time, watch another video, because every view helps my channel. Coming to you from up here in Tipp City, Ohio. The Tipp of Canoe. This is a really cool place.